My daughter was born deaf.
My father-in-law was diagnosed with cancer too late.
I was actually diagnosed with cancer when I was 16. The biopsy, pathology, and imaging were absolutely critical to getting that diagnosis.
As a lab director, the biggest issue that you're facing today is labor. You've got people retiring. The younger generation are going into things like genomics. And so the industry can't go forward without something to help it out.
When the eyes get tired, the brain gets tired. And so is the quality of work at 8 in the morning as good as 2 in the afternoon?
They've got their hands working the microscope. The first time I saw that 50s era cell counter, I couldn't believe it.
Microbiology has finally started to embrace imaging culture plates, imaging Gram stains.
Trying to diagnose a whole slide through a digital image is difficult to do. The goal of AI is to look at every single pixel on that digital sample, find the targets, present those in a very clear view so that the technician can make their diagnosis and confirm.
The quality of the data that's used to develop an AI model is essential to the capability of that model. And so the more accurate that data set is to the clinical significance of what it's seeing, then the better the outcomes are going to be for the patient.
It learns very much like we learn. Each image is broken down into thousands of features.
All the model is seeing is those textures and features, that's the class of entamoeba. So whenever I've presented in meetings or to colleagues at institutions that I think could benefit from AI, I use an analogy. In terms of lab medicine, this is no different than an automated liquid handler or a multi-channel pipette. It makes your job faster and more accurate.
Over time, that quality of life improvement is huge. We're happy to actually walk through specifically your volumes, your tests, your throughput. You can be confident, I'm gonna get a good ROI and investment on this.
The platform can support bacteriology, fecal, cervical cytology, bladder cancer. We will literally be innovating for decades as we automate all the rest of those tests in a lab.
AI is not coming to take away our jobs, but the people who can use AI well are going to be the ones who are successful in the future.
This software not only impacts the lives of the technicians, but it's impacting the lives of the patients because they're getting a faster and more accurate diagnosis.